Oh boy. I agree. Okay. No other three words can ignite so many wildly different emotions in people. Sus has got to be one of the most beloved and long-lasting video game franchises of all time, while also being one of the most controversial and divisive. You still love this blue thing, or you hate it. And I won't lie, I've been a huge Sonic fan for literally as long as I can remember. Me too. Being obsessed with Sonic used to be my... Okay, maybe not obsessed. Maybe a little. Oh, I'm trash. But even with Sonic's me too. But with SpongeBob. And me, every few years, this mess of a franchise coughs up something that pretty much everyone can agree kind of sucks. Mm-hmm. In 2006, it was Sonic 06. In 2014, it was Sonic Boom. And most recently, it's been Sonic the Hedgehog, the movie. The lead up to the Sonic movie has been an absolute garbage fire. But now... Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a bit sweaty. By the 45-minute mark, you will be single. But anyway, yeah, the Sonic movie is finally almost here. But before we all go see it, or not, I want to take a look back at all the chaos. But I did, and it was good. To this moment, just so we all have proper context. But before we get to that, I just want to say, if you like what I'm doing here on this channel, you can always subscribe and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss new videos when they come out. Oh, trust me, I will. Round. Evil scientist who turns animals into robots. The first game came out in 1991, and there's been dozens more since. Some were good, some were bad, some are kind of undecided, some are just weird, and some were Smash Brothers. But even with all the highs and lows and how it's basically become a laughingstock online, Sonic has endured for nearly 30 years. Mm-hmm. But beyond the game, Sonic has also had 5 separate cartoons.
Watch them all. And watch that too. You might know everything I'm going to do, but that won't help you because I know everything you are going to do. Strange, isn't it?
Despite all that, though, Sonic's never had a real feature length movie. That began to change in 2013 when Sony acquired Sonic's movie rights, and then in 2014 when they officially announced that a Sonic movie was entering production.
Hooray! Sorry.
I know, and I'm sorry to be so blunt, but
yeah,
he's not real. He's a cartoon character, animated with computers in a world that's also animated with computers. Maybe we're all animated with computers.
Whoa, we don't need to go that far.
Sonic games have super stylized and iconic worlds and a huge cast of recognizable characters.
Yes, there is.
Sonic games have amazing animated cutscenes.
Oh, yeah. Really beautiful. Exactly.
Yeah, the first Mario movie was live action, but that was in 1993 when there were like 4 Mario games. Mm-hmm. This is a Sonic movie in the 2010s. There is plenty of source material to draw from here for a good animated movie.
That is true.
I've been in a couple of animated movies thanks to Wreck-It Ralph. You can't put this big-headed, lanky-armed, one-eyed spike ball next to actual real-life humans and expect people to take it seriously.
It wouldn't go that big.
The same year Sony acquired the movie rights, a group of fans released their own live-action short film with a CGI Sonic that went viral online. So while I wouldn't say it's ideal, a live-action Sonic movie wasn't completely unheard of.
Okay.
A few years passed, the film was in production, apparently.
turnaround? Now, I went to film school, so I should know what that means. But I dropped out after a month, so I don't.
Oh, too bad.
Change anything, so whatever.
Just yeah, whatever.
Oh, but then the first teaser poster got released. On December 10th, 2018, I opened up Twitter and literally everyone was freaking out over the first look at the live action Sonic and.
Yeah.
Oh, God, no. He's so hairy. Like, way more hairy than he needs to be. His head is comically huge, but his body's proportioned like a regular man. Shoes straight up wrong. And I really don't like his hands. Those are ominous hands. Plus, he's muscular. Why is he so muscular? Did you ever want to see Sonic's sculpted calf?
No, barely.
Skipping leg day. Hedgehog's got buff boy legs. And worst of all, it looks like he's got an actual freaking hedgehog face with beady eyes and a nubby little nose. And keep in mind, this sleep paralysis demon, it's just a silhouette.
Ew. You
haven't even seen the full design yet.
That's scary. I agree with that.
In April of 2019, Paramount released the first official trailer for Sonic the Hedgehog. Okay, so it's rare that something comes out that just completely breaks everything. Something so stupidly shocking that everyone just stops to desperately try and understand what the heck is happening. The Sonic trailer was one of those. Literally every second of this fever dream smacks you in the face with decision after baffling decision. One of the first things we see in the trailer is Sonic's furry paw hands. Not even 30 seconds in and I'm already uncomfortable. They know those are supposed to be gloves, right? I mean, that's obvious.
Yeah, way too obvious.
Full look at the new Sonic. All right, we got some disgusting back quills. Gross. Tiny face only taking up 40% of the available space. All right, cool. I hate it. And they're bent backwards. Ugh. Is there a way this thing can not move? Because it's way grosser when it moves.
I agree.
Pretty much the only good thing about this Sonic is the voice actor, Ben Schwartz. But there is something unsettling about hearing Dewey Duck's voice come out of this thing.
You can literally not hear no difference.
Literally nothing makes sense here. Not a single thing.
Dope.
The fan backlash was nuts.
Oh, it was.
This trailer basically broke the internet, and for a while, it felt like you couldn't go 2 seconds on Twitter without seeing this just horrid face. And responses were all over the place. People were making fun of it, making memes out of it. A lot of people were just plain freaked out. But the most interesting responses were the ones trying to fix Movie Sonic. Tons of artists took it upon themselves to either edit or completely remake some of the more, doofy scenes from the trailer. And, yeah, pretty much every single one of them looked miles better than what the actual movie
was giving
us. And, dude, like, I'm not an artist,
but come on.
I drew pictures of Sonic in elementary school that are more faithful than this thing.
Agree.
So, yeah, the trailer looked bad, Sonic looked bad, the movie looked bad, everything was bad. And the internet
they did.
Surprisingly, Paramount actually listened to the criticism.
They did.
Days after the trailer dropped, the Sonic movie director, Jeff Fowler, announced on Twitter that they were going to be working to fix the character design. And luckily, they weren't making this a rush job either. The movie was originally going to come out in November of 2019, which would have given the animation team only a few months to first redesign Sonic and then completely reanimate the film.
Ooh, I think it's on fire. It's a very big guess.
Also, I outright refuse the idea that this was a publicity stunt.
I agree.
Purposely had them release a version with a terrible Sonic to get more attention to the trailer. It It's the first ever Sonic movie. Sonic is one of the most famous video game characters of all time. They don't need to pull that kind of stuff.
Exactly.
Plus, that idea just totally undermines all the work that was going to be put into the redesign.
Speaking of which,
fast forward to November of 2019, and a brand new Sonic trailer drops. I was super nervous to watch this one.
I agree.
Like, oh lord, what if it's somehow even worse? I don't think the world can handle that. But miraculously, this new version fixed pretty much everything. A Paramore. I keep saying Paramore. Ah, such a fanboy. A Paramount brought in Tyson Hess to lead the Sonic redesign. And this guy's quickly becoming kind of a legend in the Sonic franchise. Having worked on a
legend for coming.
And directing the amazing animated sequences and shorts for Sonic Mania. So, this guy knows his Sonic. And his work on the Sonic movie might be his greatest yet. Because he and the animation team took this and turned it into
Sonic.
They made the design, they just made him look like Sonic. Gloves, shoes, eyes, nose, noodle limbs, everything is better. And in a matter of minutes, the whole story just flipped. Sonic went from nightmare-inducing to legitimately kind of cute, and the movie started looking alright. Suddenly, people were totally on board with the Sonic movie, myself included. Well, kinda. See, as great as this redesign is, I gotta be honest, I am so disappointed.
I'm not. I mean, that makes sense.
Sonic movie. The one that would actively make me go, oh, stop. I'm serious, man. The original cut of the movie better be on the Blu-ray. I mean, I'm sure the movie will be fine as it is.
It will.
I'll always be a little sad that I didn't get to see the big-headed blue crash test dummy run around for my amusement. But, unfortunately, the redesign wasn't all good news.
No.
On top of the film's original $90 million budget, and the company shuts down before the movie even releases. That's kind of sad.
It is.
A bigger conversation here about how animation studios are treated, but I'm not the person to have that conversation. But that's about where we're at now. After well over a year of memes, controversy, nightmare teeth, and figuring out what a 30-year-old video game icon actually looks like, the Sonic the Hedgehog movie finally comes out. So what we learn?
Meow.
Meow.
I got nothing. Well, that was the video for the footaferret. Things you need to know about Sonic before the movie. Bye. I hope y'all liked it.